Hi, I'm Scott Scheib, Water Advocacy. I'm doing a fire hydrant audit today. This is an M&H 929. Let's see if we can find the year on the back of it. It's a 5-inch valve opening. I don't see the year. I don't know where they stamped the year at on this one. This is you can see the model number there, 929 on the bottom of the stack, but they don't have the date stamped on it, but I would say this is like 1975. But you can see the Bingham and Taylor valve box is only 8 inches away from the hydrant. I mean, the isolation valve needs to be installed a minimum of 10 feet away from the hydrant due to, if the hydrant was blowing water, you couldn't utilize this valve. How would you get near it? So basically, you would have to shut down this whole street in this heavy industrial park, and that wouldn't be a good thing to do. So basically, the other issue on this hydrant, as you can see, are the chains. This is a McWane hydrant, and the chains are basically, they've been taken off, so why put the hydrant on? The hydrant's almost 50 years old, and basically the chains are... They corroded so bad, they're galled from coats of paint. And so the fire company or someone, yanked them off. But the eyelets ought to be taken with a bolt cutter or a pair of large channel locks and finished taking them off. The hydrant tagging system here is, it's right there, it's an aluminum tag. And then basically there's the newer hydrant updated system on the bonnet, the second audit that was done. So they maintain them. I mean, it's certainly got paint on them, but when you install a hydrant, for goodness sake, don't put your valve up and next to the hydrant. I mean, are you kidding me? And the valve box needs to be lowered by at least 6 inches. Also, it's in a low-lying area here on the end of the street. But this is 50-year-old infrastructure on the life cycle. This is what you see underneath the ground. Is utterly amazing what's down that attaches this hydrant to the main line. But this is on a dead end street, so this hydrant would be utilized heavily during the flushing program to keep this dead end line clean. Anyway, Scott Scheib with Water Advocacy. Have a nice day, and thank you for viewing my video. And please subscribe to Water Advocacy. Thanks.